Now, slang, we all use it, from wearing boardies to eating bickies and having barbies. It's all just part of being Aussies.
Yeah, but right across Australia, different slang words can have different meanings. Take the word swimming costume, just for one example. In New South Wales, they're called cozzies. In Queensland, they're referred to as togs. Victoria, well, they call them bathers.
All right, social analyst and demographer Mark McCrindle has conducted a study across Australia to find out how slang varies in different states and regions and joins us now. G'day, mate. Were you surprised?
That's universal, though, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
even overseas people understand.
Yeah, I didn't even think that one through. I'm sorry. Were you surprised to learn just how diverse Aussie slang is? Because on the face of it, you'd think we all got the same thing going on.
The same language of English, the same Australian brand of English as well. But the extent of the regionalisms is a surprise. I guess historically we've come together from different colonies with their own histories, and it's got to the extent that you can have a different word in each state to describe the one thing. I mean, a classic example is what in Victoria they would call luncheon or luncheon meat. We would call it Devon here. They call it Fritz in South Australia and Polony in the West.
Oh. All right. Now, what you did find, though, that each state has a set of commonly used terms. So let's break it down, starting with Victoria.
Sure, yeah, you've got some different terms there. They might say bogus or bogan. The Victorians actually coined the term in the 80s, those who love wearing flannels and Ugg boots. We call them Westies in New South Wales. They're called Bevans in Queensland or Boonies in WA, but bogan is the term there. And Nanga. Nang can mean something good, but a Nanga is an uncouth Westie as well. Noff, not one friend as well.
Not one friend.
As in
no friends. A Nigel, no friends. We
Nigel,
might
no
say.
Friends, right.
They'll say a Noff.
Oh, okay.
Now, moving to New South Wales, what are the most used slang terms?
Well, we use the term Westie to describe the bogans, but mad, fully sick. There's a real contrarian nature to our language, so if it sounds bad, it's good.
Oh.
If something's chronic, it's good, just like if it's fully sick, you know, it's sort of reversed.
What if it's chronically fully sick? Is it two negatives make it no?
No, it's still really, really good.
Okay. Let's head north to Queensland.
Queensland, the place that have turned things around in a lot of ways. We've said rad and festy and feral and wrong. There's some words that we don't use as much in other parts of the world, in other parts of Australia. But take Queensland, the simple concept of, we'll say a telegraph pole. They'll use telegraph pole there, but in South Australia it's a stobie pole. So the same concept, the same item, but different words Australia-wide.
Well, what's it, your mum?
Your mum, that's sort of a comeback. So if someone says something negative about you, you say, well, same as your mum, right? But it's just become your mum, just the one particular phrase.
Right, and Scott, poor Scott, what's Scott done?
Scott as in Scott no friends. We would, again, the Nigel, the Scott, the Bevan, so the different terms for the different places.
I've been called some pretty interesting names over there in WA. What are some that we can repeat on TV?
WA is a classic because they love to ramp things up a lot. The corner store, we would call it a milk bar. Over there, it's the deli. Now, that's where we sell specialty cheeses and meats here in the rest of the country.
Right.
What we call a granny flat in most of the country, they'll call a chalet. So, yeah, it sounds a bit...
Big it up, WA. Big it up.
Chalet, nice, huh? Mountain booty.
Where are you spending your holidays? Oh, in the chalet.
Yeah.
Imagine all the grannies moving in if you called it that in New South Wales.
That's right. Yeah.
Okay, South Australia.
South Australia. That's where the Stobie pole has been made famous. What we call again the
telegraph pole.
Afty is the one place where we would say arvo. They say afty. See you for some afties, meaning the afternoon. a little bit different there. A gun. Let's gun it. That's a good thing. Animal is also good as something crazy. They use a little bit the word cantaloupe, as they do in Melbourne, whereas the rest of the country calls it rock melon. So different terms.
And Pete, what are you going to have for lunch? A piece.
A piece, yeah, being a sandwich. They might even say a Fritz piece, being a Devon sandwich.
Can you have a Fritz in the afty?
You
could,
can.
Probably.
You
I reckon our Tassie cousins have some classics.
They do. They like to do blockies, which is sort of some burnouts. Luncheon, there you go. Fritz, bologna, we've discussed that one. But the Tassies have invented a few words of their own.
I used to do blockies and the neighbours used to get the Fritzes. I can tell you.
Well, you're a bogan then.
No, I am. No doubt about that.
That's fascinating. That's great. Thanks, Mark. And what are you going to use all that information for, exactly?
Well, we've seen the differences in the generational language. It's great to see the differences in the regional use of language. I think it just helps us understand more of ourselves as Australians and hopefully bridge some of those gaps.
A little snapshot.
Indeed.
Beautiful.
Classic research. Thank you.